Now let's go back to hand rank. So we still have the same specification that the input is a hand and the output is a value indicating the ranking of a hand. But instead of having the value be an integer like it was before, now the value is going to be a tuple, where the first element of the tuple is still going to be the single value representing the type of ranking, 8 for a straight flush, for example. But then the next element of the tuple serves to break ties. If 8 is the highest compared to any other hand, then that's the winner. But if there are multiple hands that have an 8, they all tie, and we have to go on to the first tiebreaker. And what should the tiebreaker be? Well, in this case, we can just look at the high rank. So we can look at the max out of all the ranks breaks the ties. And the idea there is if we had a hand that, say, was had ranks 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then the only thing we care about is the 6. We can completely specify this hand because we know it's a straight. So if 6 was the high card, then that tells us everything we need to know about the straight and how it compares to any other straight. So for that kind of hand, we'd get the value 8, 6, and a hand that was, say, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 would get the value 8, 10. And we know that this hand would win because 8, 10 is bigger than 8, 6. So this gives us a way to break ties between straight flushes. Now we can do the same type of thing for all the other rankings. So rank 7 is 4 of a kind. What do we want to put in there to break the tie? Well, the first tiebreaker is the thing that you have 4 of a kind of. So you say, I've got 4 of a kind, 4 kings, and we can just say, what do you have 4 of a kind of? And then, but now I have to firm up the definition of kind. We weren't quite clear on what it returns. Now we can make it return a value which is the actual rank. So if I have 4 sevens, it should return 7. If I have 4 tens, it should return 10, and that'll be the tiebreaker. And then normally if we're playing a regular game, there would only be 4 of a kind in a deck. So if you had 4 tens, nobody else could tie you because it wouldn't be another 4 tens. But we want to allow for the possibility of playing a game where there's 2 decks. So we could go to a tiebreaker, and then the tiebreaker would be the remaining card in your hand, which is the card that you have 1 of a kind of. So, for example, say if you had a hand that had 4 nines and a 3, then our value would be 7 meaning 4 of a kind, 9 meaning you have 4 nines, and then 3 meaning that's the final tiebreaker. Now, there's something a little bit tricky here that I want to go over and make sure we get right. So here I'm kind of overloading the idea of the function kind. I'm using it to return a value, returns 9 when you have 4 nines, but I'm also using it as a Boolean test, saying if you have 4 of a kind at all, then do this. And so I want to arrange kind to return a false value when it doesn't have 4 of a kind, and to return a true value, which is a number, when you do have 4 of a kind. And you can do that in Python. In other languages, you would have to decide one or another. In a language like Java, you couldn't have something that returns either a Boolean value or a number, so you'd have to have another way of dealing with that. But in Python, you can do that. You can have kind return a number when it's needed and return a false value when it's needed. Now, one thing you have to worry about is it turns out that in Java, the value 0 is in fact counted as false. So if I was saying I'm going to return either a false value or return a number, and if 0 is one of those possible numbers, then I could be in trouble. But in this case, 0 is not a possible number because the ranks go from 2 to 14, so I'm okay. And we'll see more about that when we define the kind function.